Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how to manage state in class components. In this video, I'm going to explain about hooks in React. To be precise, useState hook. Let's start. I have already told class components are stateful components and functional components are stateless components. A stateful component declares and manages local state in it. A stateless component is a pure function that doesn't have a local state and side effects to manage. That means we cannot maintain a state inside functional components. But that was before React version 16.8. Hooks are a new addition in React 16.8. They let us use state and other React features without writing a class. So what exactly are React hooks? React hooks are simple JavaScript functions that we can use to isolate the reusable part from a functional component. Hooks can be stateful and can manage side effects. There are many inbuilt React hooks available. Some of the most useful hooks are useState to manage states, useEffect to manage side effects like API calls, useContext to return the current value for a context, useReducer, a useState alternative to help with complex state management, useCallback. It returns a memorized version of a callback to help a child component not re-render unnecessarily. UseMemo. It returns a memoized value that helps in performance optimizations. UseRef. It can be used to access a DOM element directly. In this video, I'm going to explain about useState hook. The useState is a hook that allows you to have state variables in functional components. Let me explain this using code. I have created a new React application. In the app component, you can see I'm having a variable. I'm increasing that variable inside a function and I'm calling that function on clicking this button. And so when I click this button, we can see the counter is getting increased, but it is not reflecting in the UI because the re-rendering is not happening. And in the last video, we tried the same scenario using class component and we were able to make it work using the state. Okay. Now let's introduce useState hook here. First, let's import useState from React. And so now we can use useState in this component. We can use useState using this syntax. We don't want this duplicate variable now. Let me comment that. And we are using array destructuring here. And this useState is accepting an argument, which is an initial value or a default value to this state. When we call the useState function, it gives us an array of two items. If I do a console log, you can understand. That is why we are using array destructuring and assigning it to different variables. Here, first one is the state, and the second one is a setter function to change the state. In the last video, we have seen that we cannot change the state directly. And so we need a setter function to change the state. Only then the component re-renders and reflect in the UI. So now inside the increment function, I can use the setCounter function to set the updated counter state. Now we can see the UI is re-rendering and so it is working. Here also we can see setState function is asynchronous. That is why it is showing the previous value here and showing the current value in the UI. Hope you understood how to use useState and maintain state in functional components. There are certain things we need to keep in mind while using useState. We have to create a state only when it is required. Assume there is a login form which collects username and password. Our requirement is going to send these username and password values to backend and validate whether the user is a valid user. If the user is not a valid user, we may need to show some error message. For that, we need one state to show or hide the error message. But we actually don't want to maintain the username and password in state. If you maintain this in state, any change in these fields re-render the application, which is not needed. That is why I told we have to create a state only when it is required. Okay, let me show you this one. Here we have called a setCounter once. Let me call it two more times. My expectation is, as we are increasing the value three times, I'm expecting to show it as 3 when I click once and 6 when I click one more time. But it is still showing 1 and then 2. This is how setState works. So we have to use the function version of this, in which we get the previous value and increase that. And so now we can see this. Okay, before we close, let me show you one more thing. Let me create one more state. And let me create another button and let me call a function. Inside this function, let me set this state. I'm not going to use this state anywhere. This is just for demonstration. And so when I click the increment button, we can see the counter is getting incremented. And when we click the subscribe button, the value of subscribe variable will be changed. So this is how we can maintain multiple states. But when there are more states, some people used to create it like a state object instead of individual state. That means instead of this, some people do it like this. And so instead of calling set counter, they can call set state like this. And here we need to access it like state.variableName. Let me change here also. Also, instead of set subscribe, I can do it like set state of subscribe colon true. Okay, let's test. When I click increment, it is getting incremented and so it is working. But actually it is not. If I click this button, this is gone. That is because we are replacing the state object here. And so when we update one state, we are actually losing the other states. So in case if you are going to follow this approach, make sure you are maintaining the old states. We can do that by simply spreading the old states like this. Now this will work. Okay, you can try this task. The task is same as last video. You can create 3 buttons and 1 counter. When you click the first button, it should increase the counter. And when you click the second button, it should decrease the counter. And when you click the third button, it should reset back to 0. But now you can try this in functional component using useState hook. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can take it from the GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.